Catholic Kids Corner. I'm Maddie Fredette reporting to you. Here's some Catholic Kid updates. The St. Thomas More building progression is going along smoothly. Also, today is the feast day of St. Damien of Molokai, who worked with lepers in Molokai, one of the Hawaiian Islands, until his death. Today, our very own Kelsey Williams and Anna Fredette are at the Blessing of the Animals. Hi, Kelsey and Anna.
Hi, everybody. I'm Anna.
I'm Kelsey.
And we're here covering the Catholic Kids Corner at the Blessing of the Animals.
What is the Blessing of the Animals?
That's a great question.
We actually had an interview with Father Mike a couple of weeks ago who answered all our questions about the Blessing of the Animals. Here it is.
Hi, Anna.
Hi, Kelsey.
And we're going to ask you a couple questions about the Blessing of the Animals.
Absolutely. Go ahead. Great. We were wondering, what is the Blessing of the Animals?
It dates back for centuries. I'm not sure how far back, but it keeps up the tradition of St. Francis, who loved animals, and he even wrote a prayer that was called the Canticle of All Creatures, in which he praises God for the earth and for water, the sky, the moon, the stars, and for all the animals, too. So it comes from that, and to just be grateful for the animals that we have in our world, especially dogs and cats and whatever our pets may be.
So what is a blessing?
A blessing is just special words and a special motivation upon an animal or whatever, whatever a situation, a home, where we just ask for God's care and blessing upon that special situation or that special person or that situation.
Is it done at other parishes?
Yes. Most parishes will have Blessing of the Animals, and it's around the time of the feast day of St. Francis, which is October 4th. So usually in the fall, parishes will do it. And it also has become an ecumenical event as well. So many churches that are not Catholic, but Christian of different denominations, they will do the Blessing of Animals as well.
So I know you kind of explained the history of the Blessing of the Animals, but could you specify why it started?
Again, I don't know when it started and how long it's been going on. It's been very popular for a long time. It's gaining popularity, I think, because we more and more we're having a greater respect for our pets and our animals, and especially the environment and all that. We care more for the world around us. So it's becoming greater in popularity. How it started or when, I really don't know. But I think it's just a wonderful moment to take time to recognize what God has given us. And that we are connected to the animal world, there are connections that we have, and having a pet especially, I think, makes us more human. As human beings, we become more humane as we love our animals.
And then you mentioned that about St. Francis and how he loved animals, but who was St. Francis?
St. Francis was a man in the Middle Ages, and he came from a very rich family, and one day he just realized that he was not doing what God wanted him to do. He had a real conversion, and he just began walking the streets and was going barefoot and just wearing rags, which are now the brown Franciscan habit. And just giving his life to God and praying for reform of the church. He heard God's call to build my church. And not so much a building like we're building, but he heard build my church meaning to reform the church, to help people love God more and to love one another more.
Do you have any pets?
I do. I have a dog. He's an English bulldog, and his name is Sir Byron Chunkster III. We call him Chunk.
Okay, well, thank you for your time, and those are great answers.
Oh, great, thank you. Can I show you a picture of my pet?
Yeah.
This is Chunk, and Chunk is a rescue dog, and I would really encourage whenever anybody wants to get dogs, especially pets, or our cats as well, but to choose rescue animals. There's a lot of animals that need homes that people, for whatever reason, can't keep the dog anymore or the cat, and they take them to shelters, and then people can adopt them. So I adopted him. He was very aggressive. He's a lot calmer now, but I still have to be careful around people. He had a bad childhood. I don't know, whoever his parents were, his owners were not very kind to him. And so he can be very aggressive, but he's a wonderful, with me, he's really good, and I've given him a good home.
Okay, I think we finished.
Oh, boy, that's easy.
So never mind her over here, but, so back to the blessing of the animals.
Who let the dogs out? 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 When the party was nice, the party was bumping. And everybody having a ball. And the girls up onto the car. And the bulldog shut down. Who let the dogs out? 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 I see little speedboat at a park. She really wants to get down. Get back, Scruffy. Back, Scruffy. Get back, you flea infested mongrel. Myself, my mind knows it's on way. Hey, too many girls calling them canine. Hey, tell the dummy, hey man, it's part of the party. You find your woman in front and her man behind. I heard a woman shout out, who let the dogs out? 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 Say, a doggy is nothing if you don't have a bone. A doggy or that bone, a doggy or that. A doggy is nothing if you don't have a bone. A doggy or that bone, a doggy or that. Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? She really wants to get down. Get back, Scruffy. Back, Scruffy. Get back, you flea infested mongrel. Well, if I am a dog, the party is on. I gotta get my blue, get my mic on. Do you see the rain coming from my eye? What the cheetah pussy do? I'm not breaking down. Me and my watch, my choice, but I can't see a lot. Any kind of world to I pick a new, that's what they call me, Pit Bull. Get out of my bed, and when they see me, they say, who let the dogs out?
Kelsey. So today on Catholic Kids Corner, we had an update on the building progression, learned about St. Damien, had an interview with Father Mike, and went to the blessing of the animals. That's all for today. See you next time on Catholic Kids Corner. That's a wrap.
Ecumenical. What does that mean?
It's all of the Christian religions coming together to pray.
You can't understand!
Okay, are you ready?
It's okay, I'm just kidding.
Alright, let's...
You know, the crayon's a matter of life. It's how it looks.
No, it's fine.
Teleported.
You teleported to the table.
That's a
wrap.
No! No! What was that? Not next...
That's a wrap!
I did it. Thanks, Kelsey and Anna. So today on Catholic Kids Corner, we had an update on the building progression.
When you see my sparkly nail polish, you know it's a bad one.
No, I just said St. Damien. I remember doing it like St. Damien and mother can it up. Okay.
We are scaring the kids.
Not as much as you scare them.
I don't want to.
It's still recording.
Is it really?
Yes.
Kelly!
Good job.
Look at you!